YouTube, this is Rapid Action Animations here for another video. So before my new film that I've been working on very hard on for the past couple of weeks, which still might not be out soon-ish by the time I post this video, it might be out in a couple weeks from now, but I'm not necessarily sure based on that, but it should be relatively getting close to being done. And so today I just wanted to review the Halo Infinite Mongoose Escape set, which comes with an Elite tier, two new UNSC Marines, and a Grunt over here. So yeah, let's just dive into this. Now, what I really like about the Mongoose is it's got a special suspension that's got this little ball in the middle attached to this axle, and pretty much it can go at an angle either this way or that way. So if you pretty much lean most of your mass to one way or the other way, you can easily, it's like pretty much a self-steering feature if you want to. First of all, the Marines are quite amazing. So first of all I want to say is that these Marines are amazing. So they have removable headpieces. And as you can see here, they've got a Call of Duty style headpiece over here, which has some nice detailing. Their eyes are not painted, they have holes there, but they have a nice beard and eyebrows, I guess. And you can just put the helmet on. You see a nice piece of armor here, which is very detailed. And I find it's very nice for the Marines themselves. The second Marine has some nice eye detailing them there with some black for the pupil and white around, which is nice. He's got some nice forehead wrinkles, nice detailing on the mouth, nose, ears, and everything. Very nice and convincing. He also has the same type of armor here, detailing everywhere. And the Call of Duty legs, which are slimmer, they're better for animation because less will get in the way. But what's kind of weird is they're pretty much as tall as the Spartans now, and in Halo, even though I never played it, but I've seen it and I've heard this many times, and I know that as Spartans are way taller, they're like, you know, they're way taller than the Marines, and so that's not accurate at all. Well, his face is actually kind of different than the older Grunts, as you can see. Yeah, the detailing on his face is nice. His hands are pretty much the same. He comes with a needler, and his armor is also a new type. I don't have much to say. He's got some sort of a mask here, I guess, to help him breathe or something like that. Sorry, folks, if I don't know much about Halo. I'm just making a review, so yeah. The plasma rifle comes with a squishy material, so it's good. You can see it bending here. In terms of not breaking stuff, because in the past I've broken quite a few Mega Constructs hands, which was not good. Anyways, so in my opinion, this set is quite amazing. I find the Marines, their armor looks very attractive and they're very interesting and animating with them. The Grunt, even if you don't like Grunts, it's very nice. And the Elite also has nice armor and he's very nicely detailed. So far, as you see, these are all the parts. You have the four weapons, four figures, the nice Mongoose, which has some nice detailing on there, some good parts, the tires, and the new system that, you know, allows the wheels to move differently. So this next set is like really phenomenal. I mean, just look at that Master Chief there. Like, I mean, oh my god, his armor is fantastic underneath and on top. The different little color shadings, details, the little black areas over here. Yeah, he's just a really great figure all around. The little piece, the armor detailing and everything, he's phenomenal. The numbers there, 117, and everything looks really good. Also, he comes with a kind of old styled energy sword, which looks really amazing and is very good. He also comes with two of the Halo grenades, which are very handy. He also comes with an assault rifle here, which has a tiny little detachable piece here, which you apply on the there to add the little bulk, I guess, to make, you know, just some detailing, I guess. Also comes with the new pistol from Halo Infinite, which I find really interesting. As an animator, I wish, though, this could slide back a bit as a recoil, but I mean, you can't be perfect. It's really good. The Brute Warrior is phenomenal. I mean, his armor, I mean, his face though looks a bit weird though. It's hard to focus, but he looks a bit different, his face, you know. But the armor looks amazing. That little armor piece at the bottom right there is also cool, and just really very, very detailed, high attention to detail on this figure. Also, on top of that, he comes with a nicely multiple color, not just one color, but like silver, gray, and different shades of a nicely painted gravity hammer. He comes with also this the new weapon from Halo Infinite, which I don't remember the name is. Yeah, so if you know, please comment down below. I forgot. And what's really amazing is if you look very hard, there are tiny little gold dots there. And if you scroll it, there's more and more of them. So it's kind of like ammunition, which I found was amazing. And also, there's some little silver paint there for battle damage. Here's also the brute like carabine. I think it kind of reminds me. It kind of like reminds me a lot of the elite carabines if you think about it. But yeah, you have two of these, which are squishy because if they were not, I mean, I would easily break one of these off. So very nice, amazing set. It's got amazing value, and I would highly recommend getting it. All these Halo Infinite sets are amazing, and I'm planning to use these in my following videos, and I'm really excited for that.